Selfie. Woo, look at that. Anyway, I'm so excited to be here to do this incredible class today with my favorite person to do yoga, Louise. She will be joining us soon. And we're gonna do almost an hour of yoga, so I hope you guys enjoy and like it. And I'm not gonna take it too long here. I'm gonna start. Where is she? Let me call her. Is she on? Maybe she's not. Let's see, viewers on requests. Okay, here we go again. I don't really know how this works. Where is she? Oh, I got some friends in here. They're all arriving. We did this we did a new moon meditate ritual last week, and it was so great. A lot of people loved it, so they asked me to keep doing this. And so today we decided, okay, Louise is here, so let me call her. How do I call her? Oh, there we go. Oh, I don't want to send her a message. I want to go live with her. Okay, go live with Paula's here, Giselle. All right, there we Waiting for her to answer. Oi.
Oi.
Hey. How's everything in Rio?
Hot.
Hot. Here in LA, it's a bit cloudy and it's a bit cold, but still, like there's some sunshine, like in
Well,
this
I wish we
cloud.
could do outside to see the real skyline, the grass the dimmer, but it's a bit noisy there, so let's do here more the quiet space.
Yes, I'm so excited to do this yoga today with you, because last week we did the new moon ritual. So we just did a little, we did some meditation, and we did a little breath work. We did it just the moon salutation, which was great for a lot of people that don't know about it. But I think today we wanted to do like a real class, like pretty much what we've been doing, like all the classes that I've been doing with you for more than 10 years. So we want to show this incredible practice that you've been teaching me for a long time.
So I will try my best to do the class in English, and also we have like a short time for the practice, like 15 minutes, 1 hour. We love to practice Ashtanga, but Ashtanga, the traditional Ashtanga practice, it's not what we're gonna do today. We're gonna do like a version inspired of the Ashtanga postures. And like the mainly postures, and at the end we do a little pranayama, so when we end everybody can rest, and which is very important after the practice, take some time to lay down and rest, so all the benefits can settle down and you will be really feeling good in peace.
Amazing. All right, I think we should start. I wanted to how do I turn off the comments here?
Yeah,
What does that mean? No.
let's
Oh
see
my God,
here.
people have questions already. Guys, I'll try to answer that after.
Yeah,
Turn
so we
off.
can be more focused on the practice and.
Exactly. So let's see something here. The problem is I have no idea how to do that. Oh,
I'm
here,
gonna keep
comments.
my
Wait, wait, wait. Turn off comments. It's perfect.
Okay.
There we go. So I turn off the comments. Maybe after we finish the practice, I will turn on again, say hi to a few people, and maybe we can answer some questions later. But
Okay.
let's start.
So let's get started. Just for a start, we can sit for a little bit and close the eyes and get in touch with your breath. Relax your face, the body. And just try to bring all your presence, like physical presence, your mind, your heart, your soul to this moment here and now. Yoga only happens in the here and now. So pay attention to your breath. That's the best way to connect to the present moment. Take a deep breath. Try to feel your emotions, sensations. And bring the attention to the center of your chest, your heart. We are gonna bring the hands in prayer. And I would love to do like a mantra for Ganesh. Ganesh is the removal of obstacles, especially the ones that we have inside of us, inside of our minds, our fear, our anxiety. So we're gonna do Om, and then I will sing the Ganesha Maha Mantra. Inhale. Patigan hava mahe kavin kavinam upamashravastamam jeshtarajam brahmanam brahmanas patanas shrambam utibhisi dasadanam om shrim maha Namaha. And inhale. And exhale, bring your head to your chest, to your hands, in devotion of your inner guru. And slowly relax your arms and open your eyes. I love the Sanskrit power, because even if we don't understand, we get the vibration of this beautiful language, and it's so sacred and brings us peace inside. So we are gonna speak mainly English, but remember that yoga comes from the heart. So if in the middle of the practice I say something in Portuguese, it's just like coming from my heart, and try to connect and stay with your breath. That's the most important thing, okay? Let's get it on.
Yes, let's do it.
All right.
Bye.
Let's do it. So.
Você vai colocar a música?
Vou voltar.
Okay. That's so, guys, true. All you need right now is a mat and water bottle if you need.
Yeah, it's not very good to drink water during the practice, because all the sweat, you know, it's part of the purification process. And when we drink water, what happens is our energy goes to that, to clean the water. So we need the energy like moving, you know. So try to drink afterwards. And as I said, we're going to do like a short version. So we start in Tadasana, which is the mountain pose, and we're going to do like 5 sun salutations. The sun salutation is very important because it brings like energy to cleanse the body. So we can, after that, we can do the postures and go deep. Okay?
Right.
How is that? You can see me?
Yep. I see you.
Yeah. Okay, so in front of your mat. Again, you bring your hands in front of the chest. And inhale up. Look up to the thumbs. Exhale all the way down. You can touch your legs or the floor if you can. Just relax your head. Inhale, look up. And then place your hands to the floor and step back and go to the plank position. Here, if you can, you go down. But if you need, you can bend your knees and put on the floor. So on an exhalation, you go down a little bit or all the way. Inhale, up dog. And exhale, down dog. For 5 breaths. Relax your head. And stay here for 5. You can exhale and look forward and step or jump. Inhale, look up. Exhale, release. Press the floor with your feet and come up all the way, looking to your hands. Inhale and exhale, release. We are gonna do that again. 4 more times in the flow. Inhale up. Exhale. Stay with the breath. Jai Pranayama. Breath with the sound. Inhale, look up. And again, hands to the floor. Step back with or without the knees. Come down all the way. Inhale, open the chest, lift your chin, look up. And exhale, down dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Make sure your feet is hip distance apart. Press your hands. It's very important to press the L, like the big finger, so your wrist is not twisted. And bring your abdomen to the back so you can engage your bandhas. And stay there for another 2 breaths. You can even look to your belly to engage your Jalandhara bandha. And in the next exhalation, look forward. You can bend the knees, step or jump. Inhale, look up, and exhale. Inhale, come up, and exhale, release. So one more time, I'm gonna guide you, and the last 2, we are gonna do just breathing. Inhale, come up, exhale, all the way. Remember, you can bring your hands to your chin. Inhale, look up. So step or jump back and go down Chaturanga. Inhale, up. Exhale, down dog again. Stay here for 5 breaths. This is your rest pose. It can sound a little bit like, oh, how I'm gonna rest here, but it's supposed to be our resting pose. So try to find like a comfort zone in the pose so you can stay there, stretch the back of your legs. It's not important to bring your heels to the floor, but to lift your sitting bones all the way up to the ceiling. So stay here. Yeah. Good breathing, Ali. We Ujjayi Pranayama. This breathing is so important. It gives you power. And exhale all the way. Look forward and step or jump. Inhale, look up. And exhale, release. Inhale up. And exhale. So, two more times. Just on the floor. Last one, look forward, step or jump, inhale, look up, exhale, press the floor with your feet, come all the way up, and release your arms. Last Surya Namaskar, inhale, and stay with your breath. Step or jump back. And down dog for the last five breaths. One. Two. Three, four, and five. Inhale, exhale. Inhale all the way up. And exhale back to Samasthiti. Mountain posture. So now you're gonna open our feet hip distance, catch the big toes, inhale, look up, and exhale, bring your chest to your legs and stay here for five. Inhale, look up. Now, hands below your feet. Again, inhale, stretch your body, and then exhale, come all the way. Relax your head. Keep your shoulders away from your ears. And inhale, look up, exhale here. Now inhale, bring your hands to the waist and come all the way up. And exhale, Samasthiti. Now the standing postures, inhale, open. And Trikonasana. So your heel is pointing the arch of your foot. And you go all the way. You can grab your leg, or if you can, catch your big toe and look up to your hand and stay here for five. One, two, three. Four,
And five. Inhale, come up. And exhale, left side all the way. And look up. Inhale, come up. And we're gonna do Parivrita Trikonasana. It's a twist. So we're gonna twist to the right side. Bring your left hand on the outside of your foot. Try to keep your hip aligned. And you're gonna open the chest. You can keep your hands on your lumbar, or if you can, arm up and look up for five. Exhale. Down, inhale, come up. Same thing to the other side. Keep your hip aligned. And now the right hand goes on the outside of your foot. Inhale, create space, and exhale, twist. Arm down, inhale, come up, and Samasthiti. And now, inhale, big distance, the right foot goes 90 degrees, the left heel goes a little bit, like 45 degrees outside, and I'm gonna bend my knee in line with my ankle, and the easiest version is to bring my elbow, or if I can, bring your hand to the floor and the arm go all the way, and you look to your palm of your hand and stay here for five. And inhale, come up. I think it's very important. Everyone, like, count your own breath. So it's a way for your mind to stay present. Count your breath. For five breaths. Remember, you can place your elbow or your hand to the floor and stretch all the right side and look to the palm of your hand. And inhale, come up. Again, another twist. So I'm gonna face my right leg. The easy version can be with my knee on the floor. And I'm gonna bring the elbow out of my knee and press my hands for like a gentle twist. If I can go a little bit further, I can take out my knee from the floor. The full posture, Parivrita Padmasvasana. You bring the sole of the foot to the floor, and again, look to the palm of your hand for five. Thank you. And down. Inhale up and exhale, change the side. Again, you can start on the easy version. Knee on the floor, gentle twist, or you can go a little bit deeper to the full posture. And bring your arm down. Inhale up and exhale samasthiti. Now inhale, bring your hands to the waist, just second. Your hand, I'm sweating.
Me too. Your,
good. Your feet is now like parallel, hands to the waist, and try to bring your elbows like back aligned with each other. Like pelvis up, inhale, open the chest, and exhale, come down like 90 degrees. Bring your hands in line with the arch of the feet. Look to the top of the nose, inhale. And now try to bring the head to the floor. If you can't bring the head, if you can't touch the head, it's okay. Just stay there for 5 breaths. And inhale, look up. Exhale here. Now bring the hands on the waist. Inhale all the way up and exhale here. Inhale, stretch your arms. Exhale, bring back to the waist. Again, elbows back, heart open, chest up, pelvis, and exhale all the way, keeping the hands on the wheel, on the waist. Stay here for 5. Inhale all the way up. Exhale. Inhale, arms. Exhale. Interlace your fingers like at the back and open the chest and exhale all the way up. If you can touch your head, do it. If not, it's okay. If you need to bend a little bit your knees, do that and breathe. Again, all the way up. Inhale. And hands to the waist. Exhale. Last one. Inhale. Exhale. Now, grab your big toes. Look to the tip of your nose. And bend the elbows. And bring the head to the floor if you can. And stay here. And inhale, look up, exhale, bring your hands to the waist and come all the way up, arms, and samasthiti here. I'm gonna like sweating, it's like a hot yoga.
Yeah.
Now, the last standing posture, Padmasana. So you can grab your elbows or bring your hands on your back. Give a little step with the right foot and turn all the way to the right side. Inhale, open your chest and exhale, go all the way down, keeping your hip aligned. Try to bring your chin to, it's always confusing these two words for me. Queixo na canela.
The chin to your ankle.
Não, ankle é tornozelo, não é?
Ah, a canela, não sei, eu acho que eu também.
É parecido com chin, por isso que eu sempre confundo. Press your right foot to the floor and inhale, come all the way up and exhale down. Chin to the chin, something like this.
Confusing for us. I don't even know, and I've been living here for more than half of my life.
And inhale up, step forward, release your arms, samastitihi, and we're gonna do a transition to the sitting posture. So inhale, arms up, exhale all the way down. Inhale, look up, exhale, step or jump, chaturanga. Look up, down dog, and you can sit crossing legs or jump through to the sitting posture. Good. What time is it, Ali?
We're good. We still have half an hour to go. So I hope you guys are enjoying our... This is an Ashtanga practice, right, Lou?
Yeah. It's not the traditional because I'm not counting in Sanskrit. And the way we learn Ashtanga is through the Mysore style. But it's like a short version of Ashtanga.
Mm-hmm.
So now... We're gonna sit up. I'm gonna just put my towel because I love to practice with these towels, so it's easier to do all the transitions. And now bring your sitting bones to the floor. This is really important. Activate your feet, open the chest, place your hands beside your hips. And stay here for five with the chin a little bit down, like you're looking to your chest. And stay for five. It's like a calming down from all the standing postures. Again, be with your breath, calming the mind and bringing all the energy from the bottom of your spine all the way up to the top of your head, which is our Sahasrara chakra. So now you bring your chin back. Paschimottanasana. We're gonna grab the big toes. Inhale and exhale. Always for five breaths. Inhale, open the chest, and we go a little bit deeper. So you can take the side of your feet or take your wrist and go a little bit further. Yeah, very good, baby. Inhale, look up, exhale, release. So what we do in the Ashtanga practice is the transitions, like we are always moving. So even in the sitting postures, it's not passive. We are always like activating, like warming up our blood. So the easy way to do is like cross the legs, place your hands, and go back to the plank and go all the way down. Inhale up, exhale, down dog, and I'm gonna again jump through, jump forward, good. Now, bring your hands like a little bit back from your shoulders. The easy way is with the feet to the floor and the knees bent. The full posture, the legs are stretched.
I'm gonna do the easy way always, and you do the other version.
Okay. So you do the easy way, right?
Yeah.
And I do the full posture. So inhale up and exhale. Look back. Look the tip of the nose or between your eyebrows and stay here. And again. Bring your head back, bring your hip back. You're gonna do the easy way, and I'm gonna do the full way of the transition. So cross, lift, jump. Inhale, exhale. And again, jump forward. Right. So now we're gonna jump a few postures from the sequence, the traditional sequence. And I'm gonna do one that I love. I think it's very important. Janu Sirsasana. So your heel, right heel, comes here, touching the perineum. And the knee, it's like 90 degrees. So I'm gonna twist my body in line with my left leg. And again, I can grab the sides of the foot or my wrist. Inhale, create space, and exhale all the way down. Inhale, look up. And exhale, release. Instead of jumping now, we're gonna do an exercise just to lift up so we can feel our bandha. So cross legs. Yeah, you can just for, and like try to come out of the floor. So like bring the legs close to the chest, and the movement is like up and back.
Okay, for how long?
No, just like lift and come back. So inhale up and back. Good. Now left side. Remember, like sitting bone. Grab the wrist or the foot. Inhale and exhale. One. Two. Three, four, and five. Inhale, look up. Exhale, release. And now,
thank
transition. Yep. So oh. Cross legs, sit up, and chaturanga. Inhale, and exhale. One more. Jump forward. Good. Right foot to the floor. So activate your left foot. And we can do the easy version, like the simple twist, or the full twist. Marichyasana de
remember, I'm like not following the full sequence. We have no time for that. It's just like the main postures. And stay here for 5. Exhale, release. Inhale, just lift up. And other side. So, first, inhale, up, and then I twist. Remember to activate your right foot now. Nice. Exhale, release. And again, cross legs. Lift up. Chaturanga. Inhale, up. Exhale. Now, jump, sit. And we're going to do Navasana, the boat pose. The easy version with the knee bend. Arms like that, or you can stretch the legs and stay here. Five. Cross, lift. And again, we're gonna do 3 times in this Ashtanga. We do 5. So I'm a good teacher. Yeah. Again. And 5. Up. Last one.
Wow. I need water after this.
It's almost finishing. You're strong, baby. Go. We need to be strong, you know? In times like this. Phew, last one. Cross legs, hands to the floor, step or jump. Inhale. And exhale. Whew, jump. And lay up back to the floor. Wow.
Wait, I've just drank some water.
Okay, so Setubandhu Sarvangasana. Now that we opened our body, our legs, the back of our legs, we're going to open the chest. Mm-hmm. So with the feet hip distance apart, I'm going to lift my hips. I'm going to interlace my fingers and bring my shoulders down. And now chest up. Chest to the chin and stay here for 5. And slowly go down. So you can do that one more time. Or we can go to Urdhva Dhanurasana, which is the bridge.
Okay.
So you can choose. So if you are at home and you never did the bridge before, please do that again, okay? Otherwise, we can go a little bit further. Place your hands to the floor and inhale, come up. And come down. Woo. Bring your legs to the chest. Stay here a little bit.
How good is that?
Amazing. I haven't done this practice in so long. Last time was in the beginning of the year, so it feels so good.
Yeah, I miss you, baby.
Yes.
So, how are you feeling for like an inversion? Should we do it or not?
I'm not gonna do it today.
Okay, so I think it's better because.
But
you
people
know,
can do it. They want to do it.
Home, it's gonna be
yeah,
hot.
If they want to do an inversion, if they know what they're doing, they can
yeah.
do. Maybe we'll do something different, like an option, like a different option.
Yeah,
or...
I prefer like this. So we do another transition and we prepare for the sitting final postures, okay?
All right.
So cross legs, hands, plank, all the way down. Inhale, up, down dog. And jump forward. Good. So now I can. I'm like so sweaty. Good. Phew.
Well, it's Rio de Janeiro. And it's summer
yeah.
all year long there.
Love Rio. I'm a summer girl. I, you know, endless summer forever for me. So if you can, like, do Padmasana, which is the full. Lotus pose, if it's that's too difficult for you, you can do just one leg or like cross in the middle of the legs. It's like the simple, easiest way. If you can do with one, it's good. If you can do the full Padmasana, even better, okay? So here, we can catch our elbows or the big toes. It's called Yoga Nidrasana. And we go all the way down. Calm your breath. Now, come all the way up and bring your hands like this. Oh, hi, Netuno.
Your hands like your the thumb, yeah. Like
yes.
Everything is okay, guys. Aww.
Excuse me, Netuno.
Que lindo.
And now, yeah, here. So all the bandhas should be active. Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, and Jalandhara Bandha. We're going to bring our chin a little bit down and stay here for 10 breaths. It's not a meditation, but it's like the meditation posture. So again, the energy that was awakened and the first chakra comes all the way up through the spine for our Sahasrara, our seventh chakra. Which is our like divine channel, the channel with the divine. So stay here, keep breathing. Calming your mind, your sensations, feeling your sensations and calming the mind. The eyes are like soft open, they're very soft. And again, look up. What do you think? Should we do like a pranayama?
Okay, whatever. I'm just
okay.
We
do like a simple one. I think it's so important. And it's a pranayama called Nadi Shodhana. It's very good to balance, to bring balance. So in times like this, we feel so anxious or like fear. Fear for Ayurveda, it's like a cold feeling. It's like a cold sensation. So what the medicine for fear, it's love and everything that's warm. So we need to warm up our body. That's why this practice is so good.
to, you know, get rid of the fear, bring love to our body, to our heart, to our mind, trust, hope. So what we're going to do with the right hand, I'm going to bring these two fingers down and close my right nostril. And we're going to inhale through the left, exhale, and then I change and exhale through the right. Okay. So I'm going to do that like 3 or 5 times each side, okay?
All right. So close right,
close the right.
Right now and
yeah.
Move to the left.
And inhale to the left. Now close the left and exhale to the right. And again, close the right, inhale through the left. Close the left, exhale through the right. Close the right, inhale through the left. Close the left, exhale to the right. Close the right, inhale through the left. Close the left, exhale through the right. And last one, close the right, inhale to the left. Close the left and exhale to the right. Now, inhale through the right. Close the right, exhale through the left. Close the left, inhale to the right. Close the right, exhale to the left. Close the left, inhale to the right. Close the right, exhale to the left. Close the left, inhale to the right. Close the right, exhale to the left. And the last one. Close the left, inhale to the right. Close the right, exhale to the left. And now bring your arm down and inhale. Exhale. Again, inhale. And exhale. Bring your hands in front of the chest. Deus, Pai Criador, Vida, Mãe Natureza, Mestres, Anjos, Espíritos de Luz, abençoai-nos em nossos esforços em prepararmos o corpo e a mente para que o Espírito evolua a ti. Que todos os seres em todos os lugares sejam unidos, nutridos, protegidos, que sejam felizes, livres e que haja paz, paz, paz. Que assim seja, porque assim é. Namastê.
Namastê.
Thank you.
Passamos do horário, deixa eu ver.
Não.
Ah, certinho.
We're still here. Thank you so much for this amazing practice. I hope everyone at home enjoyed, because it's such a, you know, it's a very strong and powerful practice. And then the breathing in the end, it's incredible. We need this, you know, we all need to support each other. I'm so happy that you joined me with all your knowledge to show, you know, everyone, like people all over the world can see this and they can practice with us. It's such a great way to connect.
I think yoga is a gift. And as a teacher, what I wish is like to give this to people so they can have this as a tool, you know, for themselves to practice where they are. So mm-hmm. now that we are at home, you know, we need to be in where we are, even like keep moving, you know, breathing and the mantras, the breath. It's so important in this day. So thank you.
And thank you so much, Lu. And I know that on your Instagram, on your account, you said that you might be doing some meditation, right?
Yeah, I might do on the full moon on Tuesday, mm-hmm. I think.
All right, so for whoever is interested, just follow Lulu's out. Her Instagram is tagged on my stories. And follow her. She does amazing meditations. We might come back next week with another practice, you know, and I hope everyone enjoyed. And if you're just arriving now, this is going to be available for 24 hours on live. And hopefully I'm going to try to make this in the Instagram TV, the IGTV.
Yeah.
And we can have it available at the Gal Floripa account. We're going to have it available there forever. So, you know, anytime you need it, we'll be there.
Yeah. Thank you, Ari. Guys, all my love.
Obrigada, professora.
Obrigada, meu amor.
You know, she's not just my yoga instructor, teacher, but she's like kind of like my guru and an amazing friend. We, you know, we miss each other so much, but at least we can get and be connected like this. So
we are connected here. So
What? Yeah, so sisters,
for sure.
And you know, now I get to share you with everyone that follows me and all my fans and everyone, so they get to know how amazing you are. So
thank you
so much for your time.
Thank you. Mwah.
Mwah. Bye.
Bye, everyone. Have a great day.
Bye.
Let's see her. All right.